And he had also trusted in Abraham because he know Abraham had trusted in God. So by him going out doing it, that made him be the most trusted person that Abraham knew. And he knew that Abraham already had a relationship with God, so he didn't see anything wrong with going to try to find Isaac a mate. And sometimes when we be a servant, it's all about being obedient and being humble. And don't take it the wrong way when your master or your pastor or your elder asks you to do something. Just do it, because, you know, this is a mission, and it could be a test for you to see, can you go ahead and be humble and be obedient? It says in Hebrews 13 and 17, remember them which have rule over you, who have spoken unto the word of God, whose faith follow, considering the end of their conversation. How do you expect to be a leader if you can't be a servant? We have to learn how to serve. If we want to be a leader, we have to be a servant first before we become a leader. And at this time, a moment, the servant was being a leader. He wasn't even a servant anymore. He was actually being a leader because he was being led by the Holy Ghost. He was doing exactly what his master told him to do. See, it was so easy for Abraham's servant to obey him because of Abraham's track record of faith. Abraham was a praiser. He was a worshiper. He loved God. He had so much faith in God. He trusted in God. And obviously, Abraham had some kind of conversation or something going on with God in order for him to even send a servant out to go look for a chosen mate for Isaac. So along the way, sometimes it seems like when we're doing stuff for our master, it seems like it's a hard thing to do, but really, it's really not hard. It's just something that we have to do, when we have to let, in order for us to follow our faith, we have to also look at the faith of our master, our pastor, or what have you. If you can follow their faith and they ask you to do something, please believe that it's all about and it's all in the will of God. And it should be a domino effect, especially if you are eldest servant. We have to kind of mirror the faith of that person. If that person tells us to follow after God, then we have to follow after God as well. Just like if Pastor Connor, you know, if he praying, he come to prayer every day. That's just being an example of following after him. He don't tell us to come to prayer. He'll say, y'all can come to prayer, but it's up to us to follow that example after him was coming to prayer and get some kind of prayer in our life. See, this servant was prepared mentally and spiritually, and not to mention physically, because in the lesson it said he had to go a long, long way to try to find all the way back to where Abraham came from, because Abraham didn't want his son to be mating with the Canaanites. He wanted him to go back where I came from. I know there's some good people. Go back there and find me, my son or wife, way back there, because I don't want him to be connected to somebody that's ungodly, somebody that's idolizing. I need him to go get someone that's going to be nurtured, a friend, somebody that's got a good heart, somebody going to have good intentions. In verse 11 and 12 said, and he made his camels to kneel down without the city by a well of water at the time of the evening, even the time that women go out to draw water. And he said, O Lord God of my master Abraham, I pray thee, send me good speed this day and show kindness unto my master Abraham. To me, this is like the pray behind your back that we have in Jesus' people. He was praying for someone that had taken care of him, had fed him, put a roof over his head, or, you know, whatever case may be. He was praying for someone behind their back because he realized that Abraham had really took care of him, and he knew that Abraham wasn't physically able to go out and find a wife for his son. So when he was saying, send me good speed, he was saying, what I need, God, it's for you to give me some success today. I need some success in my journey. I need you to be with me 100%. I need you to make sure that I find Isaac a mate. He was saying, I need you, Lord. He was saying, I can't do this by myself. He was praying unselfishly, because he knew that this was it was like a 911, because Abraham was like, my son, his mama's gone, I'm gonna be gone in a minute, so I need someone to be here with my son. Not to say that Isaac was alone, but he still wanted Isaac to have him a bride. It says he sit down and he prayed. So that's the first thing he did. He kneeled down at the water of well and he prayed. That's the first thing we all know in our lives, that we want God to do something for us. We have to go to God in prayer. And God will come immediately. It said in James 5:16, part A says, the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. Abraham's servant had an effective, righteous prayer. He knew that he already had saw how Abraham was the right-hand man of God. They had a good relationship together. So he also tried to mirror the way that Abraham was praying. So he was saying, God, if you can do it for Abraham all the other times, I know you can do it for him this time. Even though it's not Abraham praying, it's me praying, but I know you will come through and make something happen. And see, we have to understand that when we pray, sometimes we have to know that our motives matters and our attitudes matters as well. When he went to pray for Abraham, he wasn't thinking about himself. He didn't say, well, I ain't gonna pray for his son, I'm gonna pray for my own son. And see, let my own son get a wife, because they blessed and they had a favor, they'll find somebody else. No, he came to get what was supposed to be done, to get a wife and a mate for Isaac, his master's son. And by him sitting at the well, God was waiting on a confirmation. And when we go to prayer, I call it the PHP. We have to pray from a pure-hearted prayer. If you don't pray from a pure-hearted prayer, your prayers may not get answered. See, he had so much loyalty to Abraham that he knew that his prayer had to be strong, and that he knew that it had to go forth, because he was praying from a pure heart. If we don't pray from a pure heart, God ain't gonna, he not gonna answer. He gonna go to the next person. It could be you and somebody else. But if you ain't praying from pure heart, and they are, he gonna answer their prayers first.